I'm now going to read a post by the creator of Bitcoin. Dr. Craig is right. This particular, let's call it article, it's a post in sections on Twitter, is about the Bitcoin Core, the one with the ticker symbol BTC. So here we go. BTC, in its current form, functions almost entirely as a speculative asset. This is unsustainable. And when that speculation fades, it will collapse with astonishing speed. The reality is that BTC has no practical use beyond being a vehicle for speculation. It cannot scale, its transaction fees are sky high, and it no longer serves the purpose it was originally designed for, a micropayment system and timestamp server. When people realize this, the price will inevitably fall, and with that, the entire system will unravel. Let's break this down. Nodes, the backbone of any blockchain, must be compensated for their work. In the case of BTC, they are currently being compensated with high transaction fees and block rewards. But as soon as the price drops, the income nodes earned from mining will no longer be able to cover the basic cost of operation, such as electricity and maintenance. Once it becomes unprofitable to run nodes, miners will exit the network, causing a reduction in hash power, which in turn makes the network less secure. The so-called solutions, like the Lightning Network, only accelerate BTC Core's collapse. By pushing transactions off-chain, Lightning takes away the very fees that nodes rely on for sustainability. Nodes that are supposed to verify transactions and maintain the integrity of the blockchain are now left with even fewer transactions to process, reducing their income further. This undermines the entire system. Lightning may claim to solve the scalability issue, but it does so by removing transactions from the blockchain, stripping nodes of transaction fees that are essential to their operation. As more users are pushed onto off-chain solutions like Lightning, the already fragile BTC network becomes increasingly starved of the fees needed to maintain its infrastructure. In short, these supposed fixes only weaken the foundation of BTC Core, hastening the inevitable collapse by driving miners and nodes out of the network, leaving an empty shell of a system that can no longer sustain itself. This is the Achilles heel of BTC Core. As the price drops, the incentives for miners diminish rapidly. Without miners, the network will become unstable. Transactions will slow down even more, and trust in the system will evaporate. The very people speculating on BTC's price will start to panic, and the speculative bubble will burst. What's left? A blockchain that can no longer function as intended, and a market that no longer has confidence in the asset. When the price of BTC drops below a certain threshold, it's a race to the bottom. The electricity costs for mining will continue. But with diminishing rewards, miners will shut down their rigs, the system will become more insecure, and the entire infrastructure will collapse. This will not be a slow decline. It will happen rapidly because the only thing holding BTC up right now is the speculative belief in its future value. Once that belief cracks, the entire thing falls apart. As less profitable miners fall off the BTC network due to diminishing block subsidies and transaction fees, the overall hash power of the network decreases. This drop in computational power leads to longer times between blocks, as fewer miners are competing to solve each block. With fewer blocks being mined, the throughput of the network slows significantly, causing delays in transaction confirmations. As block times increase, pressure on fees intensifies, as users compete to have their transactions processed in the shrinking number of available blocks. This creates a feedback loop. Higher fees push more users and miners out, worsening the network's performance. The inability to exit the network efficiently due to high fees and slow confirmations can lead to a run-on-the-bank scenario, where users rush to sell or move their holdings before the system collapses, amplifying the downward spiral. In the end, BTC Core's fate is inevitable. A speculative bubble built on nothing more than the hope of future profits cannot sustain itself indefinitely. When the collapse happens, it will be swift. And there will be nothing left for the miners, the users, or the believers in the so-called digital gold.